Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of Venn Diagrams, and we're just going to continue doing some more complicated problems with Venn Diagrams. All right, so let's take this example. How about A union B minus C? All right, so we've got a Venn diagram with three sets. And I want to do A union B, but take any part of C out. So first of all, we have to think about where A union B is. All right, so that's all of A and all of B. So hopefully you could see it would be everything in here. Are we okay with that? I didn't shade it yet. But I don't want to include any part of C. So right in here, this little place where I got some dots, that's part of C. So that can't be part of my shading. So my shading then is this part of A union B, but I can't include this part that has C. Okay? Now, another way, if you have trouble doing that, seeing it that way, is some people just go ahead and shade all of A union B. Okay. So we shade all of A union B one way, and then we're going to shade C a different way. So I'm going to shade all of C a different way. And my final answer has to only look like this. Okay. So where's the only part that only looks like this? Because I only want the part of A union B that doesn't have anything else in it. Right, where I didn't take some of it off. So I could see that this part here, right, this can't be part of it. And in here, this can't be part of it. So I need to get rid of that stuff in here. And there we go. We've got A union B, take away C. So that's one way of figuring it out. Everyone has different strategies. All right, here's our next example. A intersect B and union that with C. All right, so here's how I'm going to figure this one out. I'm going to just do A intersect B that direction, right? And at the same time, I'm going to do C that direction. So I'm going to have everything that direction. So where is A intersect B? So I have to concentrate on A and B here. And where do they intersect? It's right here in the middle. Okay, so I know that's part of my shading because I'm unioning that with something else. So all of that gets to stay in the answer. And now here's all of C, just also shade all of C. And there we go. So that's what A union B, I mean, I'm sorry, A intersect B union C looks like. Here's our next example. Is the difference, right? So we have A minus B intersect C. So I know my final answer is going to have no more than A, right? So I know my final answer is going to be maybe something in A, but certainly nothing outside of A. Take away B intersect C. So what I'm going to do is say, well, if A was shaded this way, let's start off with that. A shaded this way. I want to take away anything that's in B intersect C. Now, what part of that is in B intersect C? Well, right here is your B intersect C. See that? So I have to take away this little part right in here. Okay, I got to take that off. That's the idea. So I'm going to take that off. Try to get rid of that. But keep in mind, this part was still here. Okay, so I only have some of A shaded, but I took away this part here, this part of A where that was part of B intersect C. Tricky. Right, let's try another one. So let's do this one. A intersect B, union B intersect C. All right, so I want to shade A intersect B, and I also want to shade B intersect C, and that'll be my final answer. So where is A intersect B? So here's A, here's B. Where's their intersection? Right here in the middle. All right, we also want to do B intersect C. So now we concentrate on the set C and the set B, and their intersection is right here. So we're going to add this little bit here. And there we've got A intersect B, union B intersect C. This one's a little tricky. A minus B complement. So here's our Venn diagram again. We're going to just totally ignore the C part, right? It has nothing to do with it. So we're going to have A minus B complement. That's hard to figure out all in one step. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and shade all of A. Okay. Actually, I'm going to shade all of B first. I'm sorry. I'm going to shade B complement. So where's B complement? That's everything outside of B, right? All of this stuff. I'm shading everything but B. My answer should be A minus anything I've shaded. All right, so now concentrate on where A is. Do you see A right here? This is A. In my answer, I can't have anything where I've got this blue part. So what is left? What's left is just this right here, isn't it? What's an easier way of writing that? This, if I were to just shade this. So here's my answer. Okay. So the purple is my answer. Do you recognize that as something else? That's actually A intersect B. So this Venn diagram shows you that A take away B complement and A intersect B is exactly the same thing. Kind of interesting. In any case, this is the shading right here. In our problems before I went to Venn diagrams, we found out that A union B complement was the same thing as A complement intersection intersect B complement. We could show that with Venn diagrams. If I want to do A union B complement, think about where the union of A and B is, right here, and then I want everything outside of that. So I'm going to shade everything outside of A union B. In fact, let me get rid of C completely because we could prove my point a little bit easier by just concentrating on A and B. So we have AB, we're going to shade everything outside of A union B. Okay. Now, see if this ends up looking the same. I want to do the intersection of A complement and B complement. So I'm going to have an intersection here, right? So if I were going to shade everything outside of A, I would have all of this crosshatch, right? Everything outside of A, I'm going to go one direction. And everything outside of B, I'm going to do with the other direction. Okay. What did I do here? What did I do for everything outside of A? I forgot to keep shading. Here we go. Outside of A, I forgot to keep going. There we go. Sorry. I knew something looked funny here. Okay, so I shaded everything outside of A, one direction, everything outside of B with a different direction. And then where they meet in the middle, that's the intersection. So you see where all the crosshatching is? It's outside of where A and B are, right? It's outside, the outside of that. So these actually are equal to each other. So you can actually prove this using a Venn diagram. Okay, Venn diagrams could get super complicated, but I think we've done several examples that should help you. You just have to be pretty careful with your shading and your strategies. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.